All right, see if you can fix this guy. It's a Toshiba. When I turn it on, caps lock, and I'm locked. All on. No responding. Now, this is a laptop I believe I worked on some time ago. And don't know what the history is. See if you can quickly get this out of the way. Okay. Nothing in the screen. No idea what's wrong with it. I can hear DVD drive powering up. It's one of the models I hate working with. It's the C50-C. I'm just going to have a quick look. Maybe it's just the RAM. Let me just try the RAM. I'll take the battery out too. DDR3, 4 GB. We got a whole bunch. 2 GB. Why not 2 GB and 2 GB? Do a power cycle. Powering. Power button. It's on and then it goes off. So it turns on and then it stays off. Okay. Let's have only one RAM in there. Okay, and power button again. Numlock key immediately comes on. So that's caps lock. Could be a bad BIOS. Right, so this is the one where I disabled disabled the GPU. Okay. That's our BIOS. There's a spider in there. Sorry, spider. Yeah, why don't we just flash the BIOS, yeah? Okay, so I'll get a BIOS file for this. So it's C50-C. Okay, I'll be right back. Thank you. Okay, so we got the BIOS file ready. Alright, so we'll lose the connection and go straight to HDMI when we're ready. 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's take a backup of the old one first. Okay. Okay, now let's verify the readings. Okay, let's write one from the USB. I think I made a mistake, got the wrong one. One sec. Alright, I've got another one. It's for a slightly different model. Let's see what happens. Okay, let's give it a go, see the behavior. supposed to have a charging light. I don't even have a charging light here. Press the power. So this BIOS is not compatible. Can you believe it? The version of the BIOS controls whether the charging light comes on or not. Scary stuff, okay. So next thing we can do is maybe clean the ME region of the BIOS that I've got that once may be working on this. Let's do that then. Doing a hard drive check. Okay, let's have a look. Oh no, I didn't copy from the computer, from the Raspberry Pi. Idiot me. Okay. Maybe he's using it, let me see. That's very strange. So something's not right with that BIOS, definitely. Okay. C50-C, where can we get a C50? C50-C, let's have a look. So this one is PS CPNA dash 06. So that's what I'm after. Okay, so okay, not interested in anything there. Most likely this one. Or maybe. Where is that, UEFI tool? Nope, okay. Not much luck, okay. Okay, let's try this one. That's definitely the BIOS, but I think that size is too big. should be 81.92. How the hell do I extract? Compile. Try the other one. Where the hell are ya? So it's the same for both, okay. I have no idea what this is for. Where did that come from? Okay, let's try that one. Okay. BL, there we go. Okay, let's try again. One way to know is if the charger light comes on the laptop when I connect the charger. If you do know, we're on the right track. Yep, and the charging light, let's have a look. You can see a white light there. That's the power button. It's turning on and fan spin. Same num lock, caps lock light behavior. Let's remove the RAM, see if the behavior is same. And the behavior is same. Okay. It could be a RAM issue. Maybe, maybe not. Try another RAM, completely random one. Same caps lock light on. still nothing. It's nearly 6 o'clock. Seems we may just knock off for today. Power off. And still the same. So what I will do is actually just leave this guy on the charger, let it be by itself, go open and close, etc. It may come back on, who knows. Okay, so I'll leave it at this and I'll come back later. Alright, some good news. Using this video, so the credit goes to this guy, Refix Pro, and I think he should get more subscribers. I will in fact subscribe to him too. Okay, so what he did is he demonstrated downloading the BIOS from the Toshiba website, which we also did, and downloads, and as you saw earlier, this is what I extracted. Here is my BIOS file. It's too big. So what he did is open it in your hex editor. I'm going to open it with HXD and do a search and search for IMG. And this is not what we're looking for. F3 for another search. You're looking for this guy, starting with this. So what you do is you right click, like to highlight some area, right click, select block, and we do know that this file is 8 megabyte in size, so we can say 8, 5 zeros, OK, right click, copy, OK, make a new one, paste it, OK, save it, and we'll call this new BIOS.bin. Done. That's how you simply extract the BIOS. I don't know what happened there. Okay, so that's how you save the BIOS. And if we have a look at the desktop properties, 8 megabyte of C50, correct model. We're going to put this onto the USB now. Toshiba C50 website. Let's call it that, and maybe C50-C. Okay, send to USB, copy, and also in the time being, let's just check whether this is actually a good one or not, and that's the one, and run it in there. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. So that's fine. Let's give that a go. 8 megabyte in size. Let's eject the USB. See you later. Okay, let's go back to our camera. Okay. Very quickly. Not enough time. By the way, I did leave this machine overnight, and no change in the status lights or anything like that. Okay, let's connect the Raspberry Pi. This one is called Toshiba. Okay, the chip, the connector is not in properly. Let's do that again. There we go, that's better. Could be a bad BIOS chip if this doesn't work either. Okay, I'm not sure. Let that be. We might need to take it off the board and reflash. But no time for that, so let's quickly have a go. Alright, one sec. Okay. Alright, so let's give it a go now. Toshiba. We have white light and power. Same caps lock and the num lock. Light was on. Turned off, turned on. Not really sure what's going on. Try the power button again. Lock and the RAM lock are still on, just like before. So this behavior is saying whether the RAM is in there or not. I'm going to disconnect the hard drive and disconnect the keyboard as well. Okay, power it on again. Power button. This area is quite hot. Normal temperatures. power, disconnect the old CD, reconnect the keyboard. Okay, let's try that again. And what do we get on the keyboard indicators? Same caps lock and the num lock LEDs are on. And nothing else happening. I am thinking of taking that BIOS chip out. This is a slightly different model. The BIOS chip is different size. Let me check how big this one is. .25264. This one could be 8 megabyte, yeah. Okay, let me reprogram this one. Using Raspberry Pi. Clip is in. Okay, yep, correct. 64 is 8 megabit. 8 megabyte. Okay, nearly done. So this one turned out to be better. So what we'll do is we'll remove this chip. Okay, let's put some slots. And one mil folder. Okay, one sec.
Hello?
Okay, let's go ahead. We'll run it, let's just clean the contacts. Okay, nice. Everything is clean of the component. So we've got a nice chip we can use. Now, removing it from this guy, I'm going to do the same process. Because normally you'll need to remove the whole assembly so you don't damage the keyboard or melt the keyboard because of extreme heat. So I'm going to try and take it out without causing a lot of damage. Okay. Orientation is important. So the dot has to be facing out on the top right corner. down. Very quick. Put some shoulder. And then put our new chip. So let's go ahead and try this out. Power cable in, charging light on, power button, still nothing. Really, really annoying. Same caps lock, num lock. It's turned off now. Tried to turn on. Not still off. It's turning on again by itself. Let's wait. Unplugging this battery. Okay, it's in. Says it's charging. Nothing. CPU is a little warm. Fan spin, I just saw the fan spin, okay. Same behavior. C50-C. Let me see what kind of RAM it uses. Maybe low voltage. Yeah, it does use low voltage. Yeah, don't tell me I've been using the wrong RAM. Yeah. Right, give you a 3, 8 gigabytes. Don't tell me that's the only problem. Same.
Probably the 4 gigabytes of the RAM.
S. Let's try these guys. Okay, I'll leave it running with this 4 gig and I'll be back. Okay, I've been gone for some time, come back, still the same. Caps lock, num lock, on. Any more RAM. Let's say it's a RAM issue. What can we do? So you can see the lights up. No lights at the moment. Okay.
DDR3,
1200S, and the RAM on this one,
1600 they apparently take.
Yeah, 12800 is 1600, which is this one here, and that's an 8GB. Try another slot.
Power in and charging alive. Power button.
And nothing on the screen.
Now there was a bunch of RAMs which I put on the side. Can't remember if it's from this. So 1GB DDR3, this is an old one. This one here is a 1GB DDR3, this one is a 4GB standard DDR3. Okay, so that's an 8GB DDR3 L. And this is the one I took out originally. And let's go back to some of the basics. We plug this in. Turn it on. See if we've got the RAM voltage in the system or not. One point three four, which is the 1.3342. That's the RAM voltage. 3.3, 5 volts.
Now we did remove a coil here. Which would normally be powering the GPU. That's gone.
Okay. Still on, but we don't have anything going on. Keeps going on a power cycle. Curious to know if anything does come on the HDMI. No, this one won't because HDMI connection doesn't work because the dedicated graphics has been disabled. What do we do? It's trying to boot. It's going through a loop. It's got the power. Let's remove that RAM. And power in, power light, on, So nothing out of the ordinary. Try again. When I touch here, it turns off. Interesting. Very interesting. It turns off when I touch an area. Okay, let's have a look. Have a quick look at this under the microscope. That's the LCD connector area. Let's just clean up that area.
And that's the other side. Anything interesting? Answer is not really. Okay, let's just try this again. Okay, so let's just connect the bare minimums. Okay, fan, we don't need that. Keyboard, nope. Okay. Let's give that a go. We also need the button. Okay, so what have we got? Power on. White light. Power button. On. Fan spin. No backlight. No Toshiba logo. Okay, let's get the power. Hold it for 30 seconds. And do we have any LCD backlight? Answer is no. Why did it turn off when I touch the surfing area? See if you can repeat that. Okay,
Okay, it's still on. Doesn't turn off now. Okay, see if the keyboard has the same indicators. Hey! Fish? Okay. Okay. Yeah?
No.
Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, okay. Wo ist denn Hom? Yeah, it's the same. Caps lock and the num lock key are on. How about without the old CD connector? It is the same. Maybe it's just a rare. Sorry, I can't open further. Come on. Come down here. Thank you. How are you, Ruth?
I'm good.
Thanks for coming.
Sorry I'm late.
Yeah, no problems. Better late than never. So you cross the screen on this one?
Yeah.
No worries.
Like, it works fine. It's just that it's cracked.
Yeah, not a problem. Yeah, not a worry at all. So we got that whole complete panel.
Yeah.
We're going to replace that, touching the glass together.
Yeah.
So I don't need your password, no problem.
Sure.
Do you have any open documents at the moment? Do you have any?
Can I just check?
Yeah, please.
Do you need this too?
No, I don't know. We've got the charges here. Thank you.
Thanks for opening on Saturday.
Look, it's a garage workshop, but I make it more flexible now. Before I had a retail shop.
Oh, did you?
Business hours only there. But now,
when did you move here?
Call and make a booking. I was in Gladesville, Victoria Road, Gladesville.
Yeah.
Yeah, now I've been here since February.
Okay.
Yeah, originally in Glacial for about 8 years.
Wow.
Very cool. Any documents open? Anything you want to say?
No.
Yeah, we can shut down. Beautiful. Don't worry, I'll do a proper installation for you. So that's the complete kind of original place. The HD original. And do you have any other questions for me?
No, just come tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll give you a buzz as soon as it's ready and just let me know what time you want to come. We can organize and you can pick it up there. Easy. If I have any questions, I'll give you a call, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Right, you're okay with it?
See you.
Bye bye, thank you. Alright, let's continue working on that C50. So it's been on for quite a long time, on the charger and the battery. Actually more than 2 days, so I haven't had any chance to work on it. Just disconnected from the battery and the charger, and still on, and still the same issue. Nothing's happening. So I'm not sure what to do yet. I'm gonna pull it out of the board and see if we can fix it. Somebody mentioned that it could be something to do with the E&E chip. Maybe, I don't know. We'll have a look. That somebody is Nuno. Thanks, Nuno. So if the computer turns on, I'm assuming most voltages are there, and something logical is not allowing it to go through, and I don't know what it is, so I'll replace the BIOS chip. Let's remove this guy. Let's remove the heatsink too. And these guys. So this NVIDIA GPU is currently dead. It has been disabled through the removal of a coil. So I don't know what to really look for, or where to start really. So this uses a DDR3L low voltage. Power good, light comes on all the way. So I'm not really sure what's going on. I'm going to just take a peek under the microscope. and see if anything comes up. And I'm maybe suspecting the E&E chip may need to be reprogrammed. I'm not really sure. Okay. 3G equals to a chip, that's a power management chip. I don't know what's happened here, why I have worked here.
Why have I worked here? I don't know.
Let's have a look in multimeter. There isn't any shorts there. And this is the memory chip for the NVIDIA GPU. There's one here, two, and there's two on the other side. Hello, Hannah. What are you doing?
What is this tree?
4G. Hey? Do you want to do ABC?
Yeah.
N16S, GMS,
I don't have a list.
No, I'll give you another one. Alright.
So, Hannah, this board, you just want to start.
You have a similar motherboard.
Down a steady on a two.
What?
On a two.
On a two? Mm-hmm. Two.
So you got the another motherboard here, slightly different. DABLID, and this one is DABLQM. Maybe it needs to be programmed before I can use it, right, Hannah? I don't think I can just use it.
I don't know how to program this one. You doing good?
Are you on number two?
Number three.
Number three, wow.
Number three over there.
I don't even know. Hannah, do you know what I'm doing? I don't even know.
Okay, let's see if we can get this board up and running.
Let's get the charger in here. Okay. Press the power button. I've also got a USB keyboard, which we can check the numlock key. Isn't that right, Hannah? Plug it in, and we should get a white light here. Yes, we do. And pressing the power button. Nothing on the numlock key. Okay, I think the CPU is a little bit warm. Hannah, is the CPU warm? Let's find out. Nothing much really happening. Cooling. That's a beautiful painting. Mm-hmm. Very beautiful painting. Let's check the continuity mode. And I say continuity. No, DC mode. Let's check DC mode. It is in an off stage. Power on. Maybe the ground is not good. Make sure the ground is good. Okay. The CPU has not turned on.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
He's not on. 5 volts. The RAM is not on. Okay.
My dear darling.
Got the power.
The look.
Wow, you've done a wonderful job.
But again. Again.
Got the power. Still on. How come? Oh, there we go. Okay. One sec. Okay. Maybe it wants the fan.
15. Power on. No time to spin. I won't. So because there's no RAM, let's put in the RAM. Power is currently off.
I don't want to do anymore. I'm just doing this much.
You don't want to do anymore?
Yeah, let me do this much.
You want to do something else? Okay, power in again. No fan spin yet. So that's not really power on, is it? Power. Power back in. Turn it on. Okay, here we go. No fan spin. A keyboard indicator yet. 5 volts present. CPU power is, the RAM power is not there. Battery charging power.
That's not working.
See? Okay.
I'm not working that shape.
Hey? Well, you need to do number one first. Where's number one? Do it again.
I
know. Do it again. Now. It's working now. Right, we've got a 2 gig stick. Let's try that. Power light on. No fan spin yet. And how very unusual.
That's yucky
sheep. Oh, it's brown, huh?
Yucky.
Poop sheep.
His body yucky.
And it's the shower. So Hannah, we don't have a RAM voltage now. How come? Or did we not always have it? Anyway, why don't we cut the power? Check resistance to ground. Mm. 415, that's fine. 212. Mm. 62. They all look good. And that's a BIOS chip, pin number one. Maybe 4. Pin number 1, that's fine. What's up? Yeah, that's the GPU. So we got a bigger problem. Thank you. power on.
Makeup on Emma.
The CPU and RAM have no power. Maybe we put the old Toshiba BIOS back. What do you think, Hannah? We put the old BIOS back. What happened?
Kept doing what?
Alright, we'll actually reprogram the old BIOS into the new chip that we put in and see what happens.
Money.
What are you going to do with that money?
I want to play, Daddy, I want to play shopping out here.
Yeah? I have to give you fake money, not the real money. Yeah? Okay. You know fake money? Make from paper. Okay, let's launch this.
Hi. I like the unicorn one.
Unicorn one?
I like the unicorn this one.
You call it unicorn?
Yeah.
I don't think there is one unicorn one in there. Yeah, I know, sorry. There is no unicorn one there. Okay, that's the old one. Let's put that on. Tosh C. Okay. And maybe this BIOS file.
Like I get a cat one.
Really? Meow. Why am I so sleepy enough?
Poo-poo.
Let's program the old BIOS back with the old drive and new RAM. Maybe that will resolve the issue, right, Anna? Why is it green? Why don't you make a different color?
I'm pink.
What? But if you have to choose color here, see? You choose the brush and you choose the color. Pink, okay, tap pink, there we go. Now you can go pink. You can make bigger, you want a bigger brush? You can use the bigger brush. Okay, good. Writing down. Verifying.
Okay,
let's give it a go. Are you ready? Here we go.
I don't want to eat anymore.
It's my one, not yours.
No, I don't want anymore. This one.
You don't want to do drawing? You want to do what? You can play. Okay. Be careful. So we got power on the system. Power on. And we're going to get a fan stand item. Hey, Hannah, that's dirty. Please, Hannah, no.
Daddy, I'm the
nicer
one.
And I told you they're dirty. You have to be washed.
No, I'm the nicer one.
Okay, well, you're going to give me them back, okay? Mm-hmm. They're real, okay? You can't lose them. Mama will get angry if you lose this one, okay?
The next one.
Can you tell Mommy? Papa wants the coffee? Then give Mama $10 for coffee. And take this one inside. And tell them Papa already washed them clean, okay? So now we've got a board that is not turning on. Before it would turn on, before I would have voltage here. Now I don't. Now I don't. Now I don't. Could it be the BIOS chip is the issue? You know what? Let's put the old BIOS back in. Let's reprogram the old BIOS back. That's the old BIOS. Just gonna give it a clean of all the contacts and put him back in there after programming him again. Let's do one quickly. What we'll do now is we'll just reprogram this chip. Put it back into the system. Yeah, mate.
Just you eat too much coffee, but just wait a little bit.
I drink too much coffee?
Wait.
Oh, okay. I didn't drink too much coffee. I only have one today. All right, then we'll wait.
Just a little bit more waiting.
Just like you? You have to wait sometimes? I don't like waiting. Let's write this back. What do you want to do? Want to go back? Yeah.
On the latter pink.
That's the pink. Tap. And you choose the brush, example this one, and you just go dunk, dunk. Okay. You want a mouse? Mm. Yeah, use a mouse.
What is mouse?
You know, this is not a mouse to eat, it's for chewing, okay?
Oh.
Use this one, okay? See? It's moving. Okay, this one you press here and it presses. Now, come inside where you want. Tap. This one, this one, this one. Look, look, look at me. Look at me. This one. Yeah. Tap and move. Yeah. Alright, programming is done. Let's go ahead, and so we're now going to put the chip into the board. Let's go.
I can't move.
Yeah, don't maybe your hand too small. Don't use that one. Use the other one. Go back to using the other mouse. And use the other mouse. Don't worry. Go over there, over there. Okay, let's remove that chip.
I'm a color.
Hmm? And you know what's happening here? You can see it here. Try to fix this one. It's broken. Or maybe Bubba's trying to break it more. Oh yeah.
Is this little one?
Very little. Oh, you need to go back there. Okay, well, go back there and look. Okay? Yeah, it's coming. Go back there. Have a look. Here it comes.
Hey! do the pack.
Jason. Okay, this is the instrument C50-C. Let's see what we're up to yesterday. Bloody hell, the motherboard isn't here. One sec. Okay, so I can't remember exactly what I did yesterday. What was I up to? I put the BIOS back, yeah, the original BIOS back. I'm not sure if I flashed it yet. What's on it? Yeah, I remember the RAM voltages were not coming, and the CPU voltage was not coming. We were not getting any fan steam with the BIOS chip that I had put in. Okay. So we got white light. Fan spin, okay. So this BIOS chip is better than the other BIOS chip. The software on this is better. So now we should have, I'm assuming we should have a voltage on the RAM coil, which we do, look at that. So there isn't anything really wrong with this motherboard in terms of hardware. These two power rails will not come on with .58. That's probably going to have a GPU which isn't there. I've got a, let me see which one's keyboard, which one's mouse. Keyboard here, just like yesterday. What a weird piece of crap. Okay, so basically, so what have I done to fix this? Probably reflash the chip, the correct version, I would say. Okay, just check that still works. Power button. And we should have short that out. That's all. Okay. Okay. This is one of those repair videos where I don't know what I've done to fix it. Just done a whole bunch of things. Okay. But my initial assumption is most likely I had either faulty parts or the RAM, one of the two. But I'm going to stick with faulty BIOS as the primary cause. It's a bit more stronger evidence.
shift, but we don't want any magnets around any ICs. So this does need a low voltage ramp. I'm going to put another 2. Low voltage, why do I approach it now? That one has an X, that one has a question mark. This one here, okay, let's use this one, 4 gig. And I'll do another test.